Okay, let's do some math for fun. Here we are given that this huge number has a prime factor bigger than 250,000. And thank you guys so much for 250,000 subscribers. Thank you guys so much for all the support. Thank you guys so much for all the positive comments. Thank you, thank you, thank you. But here, we're going to find out what the prime factor is for this number. I think this is actually not that bad because even though this is a huge number, we have a pattern for it, right? You see the 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, and 32. They are just powers of 2, right? So that's cool. And maybe we can somehow turn this into an algebra question because we want to talk about prime factor. So we should talk about how to factor this. And maybe you can change that to an algebra question first. Therefore, we are going to make some observation on how can we break this number down, right? So here we go. Let's focus on the number 1 first. Well, if you look at the number 1, and its place value, you see that you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, blah, 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 blah. You have 15 things after that, right? So we can say this ones are saying 1 times 10 to the 15th power. Next, we look at the number 2 right here. And you'll see that you have blah, 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 blah. You have 12 things after that. I can write it as plus 10 to the 12th power, but we have to multiply by 2, right? So this will produce this 2 at this place value. And then we'll pretty much do the same thing. That's very nice, because we do see a really nice pattern. This is how we can construct this number, right? And you notice that we have some powers and all that stuff. Here we have 2 to the 5th power. And then all the numbers in red, they are just powers of 2. All the numbers in black, they are powers of 10. And even better, this, and that, they are all multiples of 3, right? So in fact, we can do the following. Right here, we can look at this as 1,000 to the 5th power, right? This is like saying 10 to the 3rd power, and then to the 5th power, of course, that's the same as 10 to the 15th power. And likewise, we can do the same. This right here is the same as saying 1,000 to the 4th power. This is 1,000 to the 3rd power. This right here is 1,000 to the 2nd power, and this is just 1,000 to the 1st power, all that stuff. And now, I will say, let x equal to the base, 1,000 here. So let me just put down x is 1,000. And in the meantime, I will also write down y to be 2. Again, just for the base. Because this way, we'll see that. And let me just put down, observe the following. This expression, in terms of x and y, is just going to be x to the 5th power. So we have x to the 5th power. And then for the first term, we don't have any y. We don't have any 2. Next term, we have x to the 4th power right here for the 10 to the 12. And then 2 to the 1st power. And 2 is the y, so let me just put on y. And then same thing. Next, we have x to the 3rd power, y to the 2nd power, and then x to the 2nd power, y to the 3rd power, and then x to the 1st power, y to the 4th, and lastly, we have y to the 5th power. So you can see we have such a pretty expression. And now, how can we actually factor this? Oh my god, you can actually try to factor it, I don't mind. By grouping, maybe. But the truth is, we can actually do it maybe a slightly quicker way. Because you see that for the x, right? You have 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and there's no x right here. And for the y, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for the powers, and then this right here, you have no y. Here's the deal. This expression is actually equal to x to the 6th power minus y to the 6th power divided by x minus y. So again, if you actually do no division whatsoever, you actually can get that. Once we look at this expression as this, on the top is just the difference of x to the 6 and y to the 6. In another word, x to the 3rd power squared minus y to the 3rd power squared, and then you can actually factor it. And then you end up with x cubed minus y cubed times x cubed plus y cubed. And then you can just factor the difference and also the sum of two cubes. And if you do that, the first part, if you look at the difference of two cubes, you will end up x minus y times x squared plus xy and then plus y squared, like this. Right? And then the other part, remember, is x cubed plus y cubed. And if you factor that, you end up with x plus y, and then times x squared minus xy, and then plus y squared, like that. And then for the denominator, of course, you will just have the x minus y. And of course, how can I not use the blue pen, right? Cancel, cancel. And now check this out. We actually just factored in this expression. And let's look at this number. Putting x and y into the first parentheses. Let's see. When you put 1,000 in here, you square that, you get 1 million, right? So you have 1 with 6 zeros after that. And if you put 1,000 and 2 right here, you multiply them, you get 2,000. So you get 1 million and 2,000. And the ones place is just when you put a 2 right here, 2 squared is 4, so you have 0, 0, 4. This is from the first parentheses. And then for this parentheses, of course, it's just 1,000 plus 2, named the 1,002. And then lastly, let's do this maybe right here. This right here will give us 1,000 squared, which is 1 million again, right? But we will have to subtract 2,000, right? So 1 million minus 2,000, let's see, we will have 998, right? 998, and then 0, 0, but the last number right here is we have to add 4, because y is 2 squared right here, you get 4. So you have 998, 0, 0, 4. Right? So this parenthesis will keep for that. Whew, as you can see, we just factored this number into this, this, and that. And now, this, this, and that, they are not primes, of course, because this one, it ends with 4, so we know this is divisible by 4. Therefore, I will factor this for you guys right here. Let me put down 4 in blue. Let's see. If you do this right here, divided by 4, so you get 2, that will give you 8, which is you have a 2 left, and then 5, and then 0, and then 5, and then 0, 1. Like that, yeah? Yes, of course. And then for this number, it's divisible by 2. But the deal is that you don't care, because you're looking for the prime factor bigger than 250,000. This is something you don't care, because it's not big enough, so just write it down. I don't really care, 1,002, right? No offense to 1,002, but you know, I'm sorry. And then for this number, this is also divisible by 4 because it ends with 4, right? So let's factor it by 4 times something right here. Let's see, if you do it by 2 and you have 19, which is going to give you 4, and then you will have 38, which is 9, and then 5, and then 0, 1, like this, right? And now, as you can see, we just factored this number to be this times this times this times that, right? Now, we're going to answer the question. We're going to find out the prime factor that's bigger than 250,000. And then the truth is, you might not know if this is prime or not, but you don't care because this is not even bigger than 250,000. The only thing that we have right here that's bigger than 250,000 is this, right? That's it. And for the other ones, they are not bigger than 250,000. So you know for sure, this right here has to be the answer based on how the question was phrased, right? So you can say that this right here is the answer, right? This right here is the answer, 250,501. And now you might be wondering, is this prime or not though? Well, you see, 2 plus 4 is 6, plus 9 is 15, plus 5 is 20, plus 1 is 21. As you can see, the sum of all the digits is 21, which is divisible by 3. That means this number is divisible by 3 as well. Even though you don't really care, but let me tell you, this is not prime. The reason that you don't have to care about this is because this number is not even bigger than 250,000. So this is pretty much it. Hopefully you guys all like this video. If you do, please give me a like. And once again, I just want to say thank you. Thank you so much for this many subscribers. I really, really appreciate it. This is over 250,000 subscribers. I have never thought about I will be able to get this many subscribers. I really, really appreciate everybody for your support and all that. I will continue to make math for fun videos for you guys. And of course, I will also keep making calculus videos to help you guys throughout your calculus classes. As always, that's it. But of course, if you're new to my channel, be sure to subscribe. Thank you guys so much.